We just completed the training session in the outdoor area. Me and my three students had camped at a jungle park guest house near a wildlife sanctuary. It was getting dark. Dusk had fallen. We had our dinner and sat down with a small campfire. I'd planned on giving them some lectures on martial arts and philosophy, but they wanted to know about the origins of Capoeira, the Brazilian martial art. Capoeira is an Afro-Brazilian martial art that combines elements of dance, aerobics, and music. It was developed by enslaved Africans in Brazil at the beginning of the 16th century. It is known for its acrobatic and complex maneuvers, often involving hands on the ground and inverted kicks. It emphasizes flowing movements rather than fixed stances. A practitioner of this art is called a capoeirista. If you're trying to trace the origins of capoeira, we have to look at African martial arts and the history that is connected to them. Historically speaking, the majority of enslaved Africans were transported from the area currently known as Angola. Brazil, with its vast territory, received almost 40% of these African people via the Atlantic slave trade. Now let's consider Africa. There are many traditional fighting systems originating from Africa. Number one, there is Dembe of West Africa. There is Istunka from Somalia, Lutte Traditional from Senegal, a type of wrestling. There's Morengi. Then there is the Senegalese wrestling. There's also the Tathib from Egypt, a stick fighting martial art. Then finally, there is Angolo from Angola. We do remember that Brazil received 40% of slaves from Angola. Now, Angolo is a style of martial art from Angola, which involves various kicks, dodges, leg sweeps, with an emphasis on inverted postures with one or both hands on the ground. Therefore, we can safely conclude that capoeira would have its origins in Angolo. Angolo means strength and power. The first mention of Angolo in literature was made by Albano Nunes Azusa in a set of drawings demonstrating various techniques and their similarities to the Afro-Brazilian martial art form of capoeira in the 1960s. Nunes Azusa also described Angolo as part of a ritual of physical training, whose techniques were derived from the particular way in which zebras fight. This style of exercise in martial art was brought by slaves to the South American continent and precisely to Brazil, where it evolved into capoeira. I hope you enjoyed this podcast. Thank you.